Hello, and welcome back to episode 2 of Thornton Farm. Effectively, this is 2.1, due to the fact that I did actually record a second episode where I started doing this field. Started doing a lot of things. Take the Mercy back to Tippet. I did record a second one, straight after I did the first episode. But the mic volume was really, really quiet on it, worse than in the first one. So, unfortunately, there is bits that have now been missed. They got recorded, but not much to go with them, I'm afraid, because the nothing was loud enough. Clip the verge, seem to do that every time on this map. So yeah, there's just a few things on this field. Like I say, I don't think people would be too bothered about missing a field getting harvested anyway. But I did that, and field 15 I believe it is, at the back of the farm, behind the cows bit there. I seeded that with rye, using the 939. And the cedar there, hence why it's a bit dirty. But in a way, I'm kind of glad that something messed up on that. I didn't have to send out because a couple things went wrong. Couldn't get the cedar to work, and then I couldn't. And then switched over to the combine to see how that was doing, and it was halfway up a telegraph pole. So even though I'm telling you, I saved myself some things from it. Oh, I got 15 cows as well. In that one, gave him some straw, all the straws in from field 13, the first field we did. Everything's in from that one now, so that one's ready for cultivating or whatever we're going to do in that one next. So, even though I've tipped that back, I'm kind of thinking about tipping off the next few trailers so we can buy a round baler and do some grass. Don't know why I went in through that way. Oh, I moved a few of the bales in. A few of the bales are off where I've been feeding, as you can see. But we have got the mowers there. But yeah, this one here is all seeded. It's got rye in it. So that should be on its way to growing now, so we should have something to spray at some point. Obviously nothing going to be in there with only 15 cows. It's not going to be much at all, to be honest. So we don't actually own that field. What other fields do we own here? Had a proper look at this field, this map yet, to be honest. I had a quick look around, seen some YouTube videos on it. So, go up this way. And we've got the reset point. Can make a few bales in here. Could cut that one today. What else do we own? Number 19, which I bought. And that is it for the minute. Right, so I think we shall get this one out. Offload that one there. Tractor is looking a bit dirty now. I had a problem with it and I couldn't figure out why. I couldn't see rye with it. I thought it wasn't compatible. It is compatible. It's just, what am I looking for here, mowers? It's just that I had the front hopper set on a different seed to the back actual seeder, so things weren't compatible and hence it stopped itself from seeding. miles on. In time, I'd like to do some root crops as well. I quite enjoy doing potatoes, although it's not as many good harvesters for potatoes. Sugarbeet seems to have the better harvesters with the whole DLC, which is a bit of a shame, to be honest. Alright, just check on this combine here, see how that one's doing. It's nearly completed. 56% full. Yeah, so, that's this field nearly done. Move across into the road just opposite. The field just opposite even. It's just across the bridge there. Yeah, it's quite right opposite here now. So it's just the other side of that hedge in front of us. That combine will finish in a minute. Take this one down there now. That's another field done. Might sell off the bales from half of this field. And keep the other half. We may only have a few cows, but it's gonna hit the telegraph pole again. No, it's actually gonna stop. That'll do. I don't mind missing out that little bit there. Alright, this time I must not leave 3% in there. Sorry, I got quite a sore throat lately, hence the throat clearing. Yeah, thanks for the good feedback on the first episode. It was good to see that. Oh, the combine ain't gonna fully out. I'll go tip this off. Yeah, I'm really happy people like the Let's Play. Only first episode, mind people. Could change their minds by this episode. Yeah, enjoying playing this map. It's a good map to play, it's quite fun. I'm trying to remember that lane. Which Daggerwin took. I think it's just before the bridge. That's our next field to do. You can enter it from the main road. So that field there will be taken straight to the store. No point in taking that back to the yard. Might as well get the money from it. Got hire workers to pay. And here it is. I'll switch on the beacons on the road. Yeah, I quite like that it's got a little shortcut like this. Nice little backtrack. Makes it easier to get to and fro. Always remember not to pull out in front of cars. I have a bad habit of doing that. Not really looking when I come out of a junction and just go for it. I had two videos I released yesterday. Is it done that one? No. One of Willow Tree, that one showing off, feeding the sheep out of the field. And the first Let's Play. And today, I've done a guided... Don't know what that was. I've done a tour of Willow Tree. A look around the new map. Now, the map's not 100%. It's good enough so you know where things are, so I can show you where things are. Hopefully I'll get that one out same time as this. Takes a little bit longer to put together these Let's Plays and editing. A lot longer. I use Audacity to record the my mic. And then I've got Shadow Play running straight off the my GTX 750 card for the gameplay. So I've got to put the videos together because it records in segments. And I've got to put the audio on top, make sure it matches. And it takes quite a bit. It takes quite a while to get it lined up. That's why yesterday's Let's Play, if you listen carefully, there is just like 1.5 seconds difference from what you can hear coming out of my speakers, which I've sorted that problem out now. To this. Oh. Back up here a little bit. Down this lane. Back up to 43,000. And the reason it dropped so much is I bought 15 cows. 15 cows brought me down at £60,000. That's so expensive. But then you do get quite a lot from them, so can't complain too much. Looking forward to not having to spray the fields to put the manure on and the slurry before we cultivate, plough, whatever I choose to do. I don't do too much ploughing. I might do the one-off ploughing video. I don't do a massive amount of that. Empty the combine out, the rest of this. And then we'll move it on to the next field. Ready to go. And I'm so thankful of auto combine. That was such a good idea. Whoever thought that up, so, you know. Needs a medal. Saves a lot of time having auto combine. Hell of a lot of time. Is it going to fold up? Yeah, there we go. Alright. Gotta find the header trailer. There it is. Might bring the John Deere up here just to drag the trailer out of the hedge, to be honest. Don't really want to be putting it over there. Still got the player speed mod on, so we can go faster between things. Oh, missed a bit there. To be honest, I'm not too bothered. I think we'll get enough grains and bales out of this field. I've shown a little bit of baling in the past couple, so I don't think I'll bale this one today. What we'll do is we'll get this one ready to move on to the next field, but we won't move it on to the next field just yet. We'll leave these couple parked up in the field ready to go. We'll take the 939, go cut that little field, get the little drop nose mercy out, dead it. And I think that will do for today's episode. Best at doing this. What do you reckon, guys? Reckon that's gonna go on? Yeah. Another good thing about this trailer is it does actually lock on automatically, which in a way makes it a pain in the ass to get back off again. So we'll kill the engine on that one. Kill the engine on that one. No need for either of them to have their engines on right now. Well, we'll try as we got it, got that one ready to go. Right, let's take the 939. So this is my favourite tractor in Farm Sim, hence why I use it so much. And it's also my favourite tractor in real life. I don't mind the standard version, but the Black Beauty does look a lot better, I reckon. And that's personal opinion. Oh. And you're backing up this way, it's a little bit rougher going up the other way. You can get up there. So let's get this. This field cut. I have got the mod, so you can just row this up straight into pressing the analog stick there. Rowing it up straight into bales, so there's no need to ted it. But I don't do a whole lot of tedding, so. Little fields I don't mind. I tend to get a bit frustrated doing big fields tedding. You've already been over it once mowing. You've got to ted it. I know that's what happens in real life, but something about doing it in the game is a bit frustrating with it. not the best at mowing. I love doing it. I do enjoy doing mowing. I find it quite fun. Looking into that orchard mod that I see Dagwin using. He's got trees planted in this field on Thornton Farm. What you should have done is cut it first. Done some bales, then put the trees in. Rather than put the trees straight in. Well, that's what I do anyway, utilise the field. Can't really do much to it now. I did see a comment on his video saying should get a lawnmower mod. That'd be pretty good. Anyway, enough about another YouTuber. These little bits here. It's a problem when I probably shouldn't have used butterflies in such a small fiddly field. I don't even think I'm going to get many bales off of this, to be perfectly honest. It's probably a waste of time doing this field. Might be a little bit of a wait for the next Let's Play. I know I've managed to get, I'll do like 4 or 5 videos in 2 days. That's 2 days with no work. But, I'm back to work tomorrow, as far as I know, so not going to be so much time for the Let's Plays. Which is unfortunate. Really unfortunate, to be honest. I've actually, this is only technically the third I recorded, but only be the second that I've put out. I'll leave that one there, because I'm going to hopefully buy another field fairly soon with grass. But I've kind of got into actually doing this. I can see the attraction for it. It's a shame, got bills to pay. Otherwise, wouldn't go work and do this. I quite enjoy doing this. Fortunately, that's not the real world. Unless you've got money or you're already a big YouTuber. This is that Tedder mod I was on about yesterday. It's just a bit wider than the in-game version of it. I enjoy this kind of topper more than the trailered one that BM mod had done. It's a good trailered tedder. It's got a nice wide spread on it, good for big fields, so I'd use it in big fields. But I just like this kind of style. We used to have a hay bob on the farm I used to work on. I haven't seen a working hay bob for growing up in this game, which is rather unfortunate. This is pretty much as close as I can get to it. That's probably why I like it. If anyone's aware of the hay bob for 15, I know there was a one for 13. I had a go at converting it, not very well. Going around again, that's going to be a pain in the ass. Putting grass everywhere on the edges. Probably cutting too tight to everything, to be honest. It's quite weird when I'm doing recording where I don't have to talk. I get things pretty bang on. Second I'm talking, things start going downhill. This is a nice little meadow, this one. Be good to just do a little bit of grass work. I don't know what people's favourites are. A lot of people love watching arable farming, which I like the simplicity of arable farming. Yeah, it's not hard. Put a combine on it. Bait it up some. Stick a cultivator in there, seed it, back to square one. Grass, you have got a little bit more to do here and there. I mean, after, not in the game, really, as such. Not unless you got like soil modding. But this map will be fairly 50-50, I'm hoping. I don't want to concentrate too much on arable, I don't want to concentrate too much on grassland. Put a good focus in on the animals, really. That's what I would like to do. Especially the beef farm. It's just up there. I'd like to get some root crops in at some point. Harvest them. Feed them up there. Like, you can feed them grains and everything like that. Once I've got a bit more money, I may actually get some. Alright. Well, I've actually got to buy a rower. I haven't actually got one of them at the minute. This is a bit silly of me, really. Doing grass. I haven't got anything else. Didn't really think that one through. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in episode 3. See you.